Hi, I'd like to make just a brief little recording here, video recording, to explain a few things about my recording process. A lot of people ask questions, and it's really more than I can answer by typing. It's just so I'm going to try to show you, just like in a nutshell, what I do, and things that people think maybe I do that I definitely don't do. Just to sort of, I guess, set the record straight in a way. And I have a little camera that I can pick up. I hope it's not too, I don't make too much noise when I'm doing it. When I record with the piano, and when I record here and I sing, and I'm at the piano now, I'm gonna pick this up. Hope it works okay. There's my monitor that I'm watching on my iPad. Okay, I mic the piano with a stereo mic inside the piano, positioned where it should be, I think. This is my main video recorder. It's a Canon HF30, I think, is the model. Okay, and this is the vocal mic that I've been using recently. It's a Shure SM7, which I just started using this, but anyway. And then I have a mixer that I mix the microphones in. It's a little hard to see because it's not very bright today. If I can, it's a three-channel mixer. It's got an output that runs into the camera. There's the microphones plugged into it right there. Okay. And here's the piano right in front of me. And that's, what you see there. And that's how I make piano recordings. So I have a little more control over the volume of the piano and my voice. That's why I started separating the two. I used to just use one stereo mic to get all of it, but I found that. Well, and it worked okay, but I just wanted to try to make it better because I care. But anyway, okay. And when I record guitar, I use the same camera. Sometimes I have this Fishman acoustic amplifier. It's a loud box, whatever it is, 100 or something. And sometimes what I plug into that to enhance the acoustic sound a bit, because when I record my guitar, I'm usually miking myself with just a stereo mic like the Rode NT4, and it's mounted on a stand and it's positioned where you can't see it, and it captures everything. So, and that goes directly into the camera, okay? And that's how I do that. Okay, and then when all is said and done and processed, hope you're still with me here. I'm gonna take you downstairs into my little studio here. It's kind of a mess as it usually is, but anyway. I might need some light for this, okay? This is my Mac that I use, my monitor speakers, and a keyboard that I occasionally use. Drum set that I've used sparingly, but I do use. I use Logic Pro to mix my audio. And I use a duet interface. That's the breakout box for it. And I have my guitars. There's more out there, whatever. But so, and if there's any vocal, so that's what I do. And here's a microphone that I may add overdubbed vocals. Here's another mic that I may add overdubbed vocals with. And that's that. Okay, now we'll go back up. I never, ever, ever use artificial vocals, harmonizers, anything like that. Any vocal you hear on any recording of mine, I sang myself without the use of a harmonizer, you know, just, you know, mixing, of course, you know, maybe a little EQ, a little compression, whatever, that type of thing, but never any artificial artifacts like that. Just standard recording procedure, live recording, nothing fake. I've had people say, what harmonizer are you using, etc., etc., etc. I don't use a harmonizer. Everything's done. Everything is a live performance. I even had one guy who was leaving some really crazy, I'd have to say stupid comments, to be honest with you. He even said, and I guess accused me of splicing in elements of the original, splicing in parts of the regular record, of the original recording of the song I was doing to make mine sound better. Now, I don't know how I would do that, how I would match it. I don't even, that thought never would ever occur to me, but I mean, this guy is nuts, but it was on the song Sweet Judy Blue Eyes, and he accused me of, he said, okay, just admit that you doctored this recording. You cut in the original recording. That is the most truly ridiculous thing I've ever heard. But that's about as wild as any comments or questions have ever gotten. But everything that I do is live. I mean, obviously, I have to over. I have never brought in other than my band Then and Now videos. I've never had another performer in here. No one has played anything on any of my recordings except myself, nor sang any of the vocal parts other than the Then and Now playlist videos where I featured my old band and we reprised some of our work 25 years ago. So I hope that gives you a little bit of enlightenment to my recording process. I just want you to know that it's real. It's I don't use harmonizers to fix my pitch. You might say obviously maybe I should, but I don't. And I don't use karaoke techniques. I don't. This is something important too that I want to. I never ever use tab. I don't use sheet music. I don't have sheet music. I don't use chord charts. I don't use anything. I just, what's in my head. I mean, occasionally I might have like a little teleprompter lyric thing going, like with the iPad sitting up, if it's a song that I've never ever done before that I'm trying to do. I might help myself out a little bit with that. That I will admit I have helped myself with some lyrics periodically. Other than that, no assistance whatsoever. So I hope this sheds a little light on it. I hope this recording looks okay, because I had to use a wireless camera to do it so I could take you downstairs. So anyway, I hope that answers a few questions, and it might raise a few, and I'm really glad that you even care enough. And I, again, as I don't do often enough, I thank you all for your kindness, your warmth, your support, the fact that you watch my videos, and and maybe in some instances have had a positive effect on your day-to-day life. That's what I want. So God bless you, and I hope you enjoyed this video. Peace.